Gaz, how's it going? Call it a North Coast Constrictors. No, fuck it, I'm not redoing this. North Coast Constrictors, Billy to South Africa. I was busy feeding my snakes and I was opening up all the tubs and I found a female that's laid a clutch of eggs. So I thought I'm going to quickly do and I haven't prepared an egg box for her. I didn't expect her to lay. One of those sneaky peats. Alright, so let me show you how I set up an egg thing. I use vermiculite and I do, in this particular size clutch of eggs, she's not a very big female, I do 250 alga, it's always to weight. Okay, always to weight, and I do 250. Okay, that's 200. Okay, 250. Okay, 250 grams water. I mean, weight. Weight, 250 grams. Now, zero my scale again, okay? A lot of guys make their tubs airtight and they do a 1-to-1 ratio. So 250 grams or 300 or 400 or 500 or 150, whatever they do. I don't know what they do. I do 250 on an 8-liter, on a 6-liter egg tub, okay? 250, but I don't do airtight. I don't do press and seal. I've got holes. I've got a hole on each side there because I want fresh air. Okay, they're tiny little holes. Tiny little holes on each side. Okay, and the reason why is because I want fresh air because of osmosis. The egg shell is a living, breathing organism. It needs fresh air. But because it's not airtight, water will evaporate. Okay, so I do 250 grams of vermiculite and 500 grams of water. I double up on the water because I need the humidity. Okay, so put my thingamajig on, my thingamajig, my protein shake, whatever, and I've got hot water. I'll put about 200 grams of hot water, and because obviously you don't want to put them in, you want to put, I incubate my eggs at 31.5 degrees Celsius, okay, so you want the egg box at about, so I'm just doing 5, got my temp gun, 31.8, a little bit warmer than that. It's gonna cool down. There we go. 500 grams. Boom, boom, boom. 33.8. Okay, right. That's 500 grams. Not 500 milliliters. Not half a liter. 500 grams weight water. Vermiculite, okay, double up. That's how I do it. Doesn't mean that's how everybody has to do it. This is called North Coast Constrictors YouTube channel. This is how North Coast Constrictors set up their egg boxes. I'm sorry for being sarcastic, but I've taken flack. Like, how do you set up your egg box? You don't need to do any. What, 2-to-1, you can do whatever, and we don't even measure. Why do you have to be so precise? Because I fucking am precise. I like being precise. I'm OCD, okay? I have obsessive compulsive disorder, okay? So I want 250 grams of vermiculite, and I want 5 exactly a 2-to-1 ratio. Alright. Because I know if I've done it like that, there's no margin for error. It means if something goes wrong, it wasn't my fault. It means something happened to the eggs or the babies that I can't point a finger back at myself. Okay, that's why I do it like that. Alright. So now you take all the vermiculite down. Do the egg pulling now on the video. I'm going to do the whole thing. I thought I'd do a whole once off a whole video of a surprise clutch of eggs, setting up an egg box for all you newbies out there that are going, oh, how do we do it? How do we set it up? Yeah, watch this video. This is how you do it. Okay. If you're going to do an airtight container, 1-to-1. So 250 grams. Why does I keep on saying milligrams? It's late at night, that's why. I've had a long, hard day, and it's late at night. Okay, then so you do 250 grams, and I'm talking about a 6-liter container. I work in the metric system, I'm South Africa. I don't know how many quarts that is. Okay, all right. Sorry, guys, I know I'm being probably like a little bit over-sarcastic and overzealous in this video. But the reason why is because I want to get this girl off her eggs and I want to get these eggs into the incubator. Alright. Okay. So, then, my light diffuser on top of the vermiculite. Alright. That stops the eggs from coming into contact with the vermiculite. I know some guys put their eggs directly onto the vermiculite when they do a 1-to-1 ratio. I don't want the eggs touching the vermiculite. I don't want it. I want the eggs dry. Okay, so while I'm doing the female, I'm just going to put the egg box in the incubator so that it stays at temperature. Okay. Right now, dropped a little bit of temperature there. Dropped down to about 30 degrees Celsius, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with it at all. Okay. And move this away. Please excuse the mess. As I say, I was busy feeding. I was feeding. Right, so now what I gotta do is I've got a my poor girlfriend is standing here. I'm trying to find my torch, which now I don't know where I've put it, which I used to candle the eggs. It's now gone missing again. We'll be back in just a second. Hold that thought. Okay, got my torch. It's unbelievable. I used it yesterday. I'm the worst. I put things down. I don't know where I put them. Okay, right. So she's up here. First things first. I'm going to take the water out. Tub is dirty. I haven't cleaned the tub because she was about to lay. So please, guys, don't judge me. And I pull the eggs. It could not. It's actually not too bad. Alright, so what we've got here is a super pastel fire. Alright. Okay, so she is a super pastel fire butter. Super pastel fire butter female. Very angry super pastel fire butter female. Right. Now what I've got over here, if you can bring the camera this way, is I've got a fresh water tub, 30 degrees Celsius, make it a little bit warmer. I'm thinking about 31. She's gonna lie on me for a while. 31.5. Perfect. Now, I do not want to get the eggs wet. I do not want to get the eggs wet. Dry my hands. She knows I'm coming, she's hissing. Right. Hello, my sweetheart. Now, I lost a clutch of eggs from this female last year. They didn't survive. She's not a very big girl, she has no big eggs. She only gave me 5 eggs last year. I don't know what she's gonna give me this year, right? There we go. Alright. Okay, mommy. Well done. Well done, mommy. Well done, well done. Without biting me. Ooh, okay, I know. I'm just checking to make sure that you're not egg bound. Don't bite me. Beautiful snake. Beautiful snake. She's not egg bound in any way. You can see that. Okay. Alright, here we go. So now what I do is I put her in the water here. And she's gonna lie in there. There's no soap in that water right now. Okay. Alright, now all these eggs, these eggs are clumped together. And I'm gonna leave them together. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn off all the lights, turn a candle in. Alright. Just want to make sure they've got veins. Oh yeah, strong veins. And there's one underneath here. Also very strong veins. So we have got a clutch of... We've got a clutch, I think, what, 6 or 7?
7, I think.
7 eggs there?
Yeah.
Let me get the egg box. That's not a bad idea. Okay. Right, okay, so I've got the egg box out. I'm hoping that I can close the lid. All right, but let's count the eggs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 eggs. Alright. So let's get any like substrate or whatever off here. Alright. I'm hoping that it doesn't. No. Right, I'm going to have to separate probably just the top or maybe one or two from the bottom here. This one looks like it's about to come up quite easily, so we'll take... I don't like to separate the eggs, okay? As far as possible, I would like to keep them in a clump. There's the embryo on this one here. Okay. Doesn't help me with a heart much. I gotta try and find the loosest ones out of these. These ones look pretty solid. It's just gonna have to be the way it is. Okay, I'll tell you what, guys, this is going to take a while because it's a very, very delicate operation. Once I've got these eggs separated, I'll carry on recording. Okay, I've had to separate, unfortunately, 4 of the eggs to get them in. I'm hoping now, they'll close. So, I really didn't want to separate the eggs, but I don't have another egg box that's high enough. So what I've done, and yes, I know a lot of people say it doesn't matter whether the embryo is up or down. I know it doesn't matter, but I like the embryo up. there's so many mouths. And then this, these, fortunately, these three that stuck together, the embryos are all up. Okay, so do my markings. Another embryo is there. I'm just gonna move it back. There. That one was down there, and that one was over there. Okay. Maybe just put those together like that. Okay, guys, and that's that. Seven good eggs, all with healthy veins, into my emergency incubator. It's called the start-off incubator. I only have one spot left, but a second temperature gauge inside. I don't know if you can see a damn thing with that light, but anyway. I use this temperature probe inside here. I go and put it in each box and I check all my eggs just out of curiosity. Alright, now what I've got to do is I've got to go and get some dishwashing soap, soak that girl down, clean that tub out, fresh substrate, put in a completely separate, put another snake inside that tub, take her, put her in another tub, so that she doesn't smell the eggs, and that's going to take me about another half an hour. So guys, that was video number two in a row, but I'm very, very stoked. The pairing there was a head pairing. She was paired to a desert ghost, just a single gene desert ghost male, and the object of that is to make soup. All of them will be pastel because she's a super pastel. Fire and butter, hopefully, as many as we can get, all 100% hit for Desert Ghost. Last year we got 5 eggs from her, none of them survived. Two were slugs, we had three left. Out of those three, two went moldy after about a week, and after about 3 weeks the other one went moldy. Boom. It was just the end of it. It was just an unsuccessful clutch, but the veins were incredibly weak. In fact, on some we could hardly see any veins. Alright. All 7 eggs there have got incredibly strong veins. I feel very, very confident about that clutch. I'm very, very stoked with that. Very happy with her. Very surprised that she's had a clutch of eggs. Anyway, this has probably gone on way too long. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned something. If you haven't done so already, like and subscribe. I don't know where this Kinney Master thing is. When I'm looking at the camera, it's usually on my left-hand side. North Coast Constrictors, that's us. I hope I've got it on the right side. And we, North Coast _ Constrictors, Instagram. Follow us. Thank you for watching. Cheers.